where you are.
Thank you.
Should start looking for a new head of communications.
You're listening to America Overnight, now in our 29th year, lifting the veil between fiction and reality. Thank you for staying up with us. I've been getting a lot of calls about this meteor in Sterling, Colorado. There were reports of a large spherical container that crash-landed in a field outside town. Some government people reportedly took it away. Now, we happen to broadcast from Colorado, and Sterling isn't far. I drove down myself to check it out with members of the America Overnight team. I don't need to tell you, it wasn't long before we found pieces of metal debris scattered in a field. Listeners, this is yet another instance of an unidentified flying object, or UFO, entering our airspace and crashing. That the government took away the evidence under cover of darkness only compounds the fact that these are more than likely visitors from beyond our planet, or dare I say, solar system. Head on over to our website to see pictures of the spacecraft pieces we uncovered. And while you're doing that, our sponsors will like your ear. America Overnight will be right back.
I need the containment protocol for every altered item.
Welcome back, Jesse. I took care of the Tomasi problem. Sorry, I forget he was a coworker.
Don't apologize. That wasn't the real Tomasi. He died when the hiss got him.
You're right. I just didn't want to be insensitive.
Sentimentality is a weakness in situations like these, Jesse. That's Bureau 101.
I don't think Emily's in danger of being called sentimental.
I should...
Thank you. There was something there, reaching for her, trying to make her act. It was a distress call. Faden sensed a drowning man, a hunger in the dark. Investigation sector.
Investigation sector, huh? We should check this out.
Hello? Anyone here?
Guess not. Seems a lot more crowded than the rest of the bureau. It's not working. Probably a loose power. Power core somewhere. Thank you. gate should open. I'm no detective, but something definitely happened here.
Each other? This feels familiar. I can't seem to... I've forgotten it. I'm sorry. My name is Alan Wake.
Friend Tom. Tom Zane. There's nothing to worry about.
Tom. The poet. The diver, you look different.
That was just a role. A character. The protagonist I played in my old film. I'm a filmmaker. An auteur like yourself. We're working on this together, remember? An artistic collaboration. You need a drink. Mm. they're close now. You've been riding. You found a way to escape. It'll work this time.
Riding?
You found a way!
No! I don't... Wait. There's something. It's my double. He's out there. I've seen
him. Yeah. Nothing to worry about. I'm dealing with it. It's fine, my friend. Let me handle him.
You've met him? What the hell?
Now, come on. You misunderstand me.
That was Alan Wake, the writer who went missing in that AWE case I read about. What's he doing here? And Thomas Zane was with him. The poet. No, wait. He was a filmmaker. I always remember that wrong.
Dr. Emil Hartman, devoured by hungry darkness, became the thing that had been Hartman. Broke loose, killed everyone it could, lurking, roaming, waiting. Then something else came, a resonance. The thing that had been Hartman went through another change.
Yeah.
That doesn't look like a house shift. Do I even want to know? Are already in here. This darkness is blocking the door, so now I have to deal with an interdimensional noise and sentient shadows.
Sound made darker, the darkness made louder. Hartman was stretched like a worm through time. The third thing was a monster. Now we crashed out of darkness toward Faden.
Reminder, all employees are required to report their hours at the end of each month. The Federal Bureau of Control maintains that time is not subjective, and hours passed on alternative planes cannot be claimed. Astral dives do not accumulate overtime compensation. Thank you for your attention.
Agent Fisher, day 6 inside the motel. Utilized surveillance methods are as follows. Fiber optic cameras slid under the individual room doors, motion detectors in the lobby area. Tripwire, triggering a flash camera across the main entrance, even fingerprint powder on the front desk. Results are varying at best. But mostly just inconclusive and unusable. The footage is corrupted, sometimes even the equipment is damaged. I don't know how, exactly. I think this place is making fun of me. That's the only explanation. I can hear them laughing and screaming behind the closed doors. I can hear the call bell going ding multiple times a day, but when I look, there's no one there. I know I'm supposed to stay out of sight, but I've seen the doors closing just before I can catch even a glimpse of anyone or anything. They're messing with me, whoever they are. I think, wait, shh. There's something. I gotta get this, gotta get the cable out. Come on, you fiber optic fuck, cooperate. Okay, there we go. This time, or I swear to God, I'll... What? Hello? Who's there? Oh, shit. I'm with the FBC. Move away from the door. I have a... Where's my...
Bloody seat, said the old man. Like star, but good for nothing. Get rid of it.
Hey, air is getting bad. The vents, they are full of mold shit. It's not good for you. Headache, nausea, mold, depression.
How can you tell when you are in it?
Lands and years have died standing up.
Lighten them up.
My understanding of the darkness is fragmented, incomplete. This abyss, this void, it very much does... Understood. If light symbolizes knowledge, then it stands to reason that darkness would equate to ignorance. By its very nature, it abhors comprehension. Of course, my own nature drives me to comprehend all. Given this concept, conflict of natures, we know that the light of truth will burn away the darkness, both figuratively and literally.
I don't feel right. Something in this darkness is draining me.
Thank you.
is that?
Come on, elevator, time to go!
This room is really intimidating and all, but I know my rights. It's not a crime. Thank you.
arcade machines. Shoom. Shim. Shoom. Whatever.
Investigations.
Jesus, don't scare me like that, Langston.
If you're talking right now, I can't hear you. It's a one-way system. Try to find an intercom.
Langston, it's me, Jesse.
I know. I can see you on the monitors. The cameras in there haven't worked since we sealed that sector off a couple years back.
Let me guess. You sealed it because of the monster guy.
Wait, did you see Dr. Hartman? Jesus, I really wish you hadn't opened that fire break. Okay, listen, you need to find Hartman and kill him before he gets out into the Bureau.
That thing is a person?
He was a person. We brought him here to study after he was, altered in an AWE. I forget the medical word for what happened, but now light physically hurts him. Do you have a flashlight?
No.
A lantern? Headlamp. Oh, yeah, flare gun. Oh, Christmas lights. You could wrap them around your...
I don't have any of those, Langston.
Shit. Okay, well, I'm sure you'll think of something. I'll keep an eye on you from the Panopticon. This is kind of exciting, right?
Maybe from where you're standing.
Right, okay. Well, break a leg. Oh, why did I say that?
Okay, this Hartman thing can't have gotten very far. Let's go flush him out. Langston was right. This is kind of exciting.
It's just nice to have someone to talk to, you know? Ever since I got put in charge of the Panopticon, people treat me different, like I'm crazy for wanting to work with altered items. People just don't understand the altered items like I do, you know? I don't want to brag, but it does take a very empathetic mind to connect with the items.
Still, I don't know
why people are making it so personal.
Right.
I mean, the teams in research handle paranatural materials every day, and no one thinks they're weird. Well, maybe that's not true. Darling is famous for being a bit out there, but when he's weird, it's charming. Altered items really aren't that frightening once you get to know them. If you figure out what they like or don't like, you know, what sets them off, then there's nothing to worry about. I guess at the end of the day, we're still just wild animals scared of our own shadows. We're supposed to be on the same team, but sometimes it feels like it's every department for themselves, like it's a race and we're all trying to be number one. If it is a race, though, I'd say Darling is a mile ahead of everyone else. He was Trench's golden boy for years, but that relationship has gotten pretty tense, or so I've heard through the grapevine. Not that I spread rumors, just, you know, people talk. Not me, though. I keep my nose to the grind. Too much work to do to focus on those kinds of things. I need to stay focused so I can get my work done and get home to feed Alfred.
He's just gonna talk forever, isn't
he? I always make it home for mealtime, so I have my neighbor check in on Alfred at 7 o'clock if I'm not back yet. She's very nice. Her name is Maria. She's older. She came to New York in the 50s to attend school and has been here ever since. She has a couple of kids. I met them at Thanksgiving. Big family. Very nice people. Anyway, she has a key to my apartment, and she gives Alfred his dinner if I'm not home. I'm gonna have to buy her a nice fruit arrangement as a thank you after this. I'm missing a lot of Alfred's mealtimes. She's probably gonna have to go to the store for more wet food. I'll have to remember to pay her back. Hold on, let me make a note. Pay back Maria for Alfred's food. Okay. Oh, one more thing. and buy her a fruit arrangement. All right, done. Are you a cat person? I don't think I ever asked. You seem like one, though. You'd like Alfred. He's very proper. Really carries himself well, you know? I named him after my favorite poet. Felt like a good fit. I got Alfred just before Sylvia died when I was at the... You know, I don't really remember where I got Alfred from. But, boy, those two did not get along. No. Sylvia thought she owned the place. Didn't like me getting in her way. Scratched me more than once when I was just trying to move her food bowl. That cat was a real asshole.
Wow.
I'm realizing now that language is not entirely, professional. You see, Sylvia didn't tolerate most people. Or animals. Or anything. And that's what I meant when I said asshole. I would never use that word about a person. It was just, hey, there's a light flashing on the console here. I gotta, check this out. I'll get back to you later.
Real smooth, Langston.
Director Faden here. I need a ranger dispatched to my position.
Let's put him down!